Questions and answers. Got them over, not yet. I did save them somewhere. Where did I? I've got them over here. First question by Anthony Nicholson. What kind of monitors are those? The black ones. I actually need to make a separate video about them. Those are Philips MFB 587. Not important. I will make a separate video about them. The cool thing about them is that the low driver does have a feedback system in it. That's also the name of the speaker is MFB, stands for emotional feedback. The speaker will always do what the amplifier says it should do. So there's much less distortion in the low end. And that makes that such a small speaker can make very big and steady low. Spark 972. Hello, I'm looking for your thoughts on the T-Rex 5 bundle. I've been impressed by the handling. Let me Google that. T-Rex 5. It's matching that world-class sound has never been easier. So judging from the picture, it looks like a good candidate for snake oil. So I'll put it on my list, but that doesn't mean that I will review it within now in a month. I think it will take 3 years or something to do it, because the snake oil list is pretty big right now. Next one, from Tormi van Kool. Tormi van Kool. Depends on if you're Dutch or English. What's the device behind your shoulders? The one behind your Mac as well. I think you mean my bass traps. This device. So this is a hand-built bass trap. It's actually pretty deep. It's also bigger than you think it is. It's a membrane bass trap. So there's a membrane in here with a certain distance to the box. Normally, if you make a bass trap, you also have a big flat surface in your room. And this one doesn't have it because there's Rockwool behind here. So directly Rockwool, then there's a membrane, and then there's a lot of air and a lot of absorption material for the bass trap. So yeah, I made them myself, by the way. You can see it, that I did it myself. Alan Murray asks how old I am. I'm 25 years old right now, and my birthday is at May 9th. So if you're watching this video 3 years from now, then you will know that I'm 28 or 27, depends on the date. Emphatic 001 asks, as I understand it, you mostly use analog reverb. Is this placed pre or post fader in your console? And do you always bounce slash print it to a digital file before the final mixdown? So my console has a switch for pre and post fader. So I can always switch it. And to be honest, I almost always like to work pre fader. It's a studio situation, so I have everything under control. In a live situation, however, I would put it post fader. So if I would lower the vocals from someone, it would also be lower on the reverb. But in this case, I'm using it pre fader. The interesting thing, however, is that I insert the compression on the bus and not on the single channel. So I can send an aux to the reverb from the bus and also from the channel, so before and after the compression. What's very cool about that is that if you put a lot of reverb on the dry signal, the uncompressed signal, if someone sings louder, you will get more reverb around it. And after the compression, the loudness will be almost the same because of the compression, but it will sound bigger because you have more reverb there. Alice von Gallifrey asks, how many channels would you need roughly? 100? 150? I know that I go crazy with stems and often end up with about 80 or so. I can only guess that professional music creators use more or maybe less. But you always need headroom, is what I learned in the past. It depends a bit. How much channels does a production need? Well, I always say less is more, and I think that a lot of guys are using too many channels in a lot of productions. If you need to layer your synthesizer with 25 other layers, you should maybe look for another synthesizer. And same goes with a lot of other things, like there are a lot of people that make a separate channel for the uplifter, so a sweep up and a sweep down, while they are all the same white noise sample or the same sounding thing. so you can put them all on one channel. For a studio, the amount of channels to have is very difficult to determine. What I want is that I will never run out of channels. That's my goal. It's not right now, I always run out of channels. But so the new console is over there. It has got 26 channels. The Neumann has got 16 of them. But I can fill the Neumann until I have 48 channels. So 48 channels plus 26 channels will make 74 channels, I think. And I think that will be enough. I have to say those are mono channels. So if I have a stereo sound, which I mostly have, I need to use two channels for that. So I will only have 37 or something channels in stereo. So yeah, it's hard to determine how many channels you need in your studio. But for production, if you need more than 80, then there's something wrong. 80 stereo channels. Johannes Klein. Love your approach mixing and to making videos. Binge watched almost every single one yesterday night. That's why I saw a spike in the views. They are enjoyable short. Please review more plugins in the future. And the thing is, the plugin review videos are actually going pretty good on YouTube. But I'm not sure if I enjoy them the most in making them. And I would like to do things that I enjoy the most doing. And not what's the best commercially seen. So I will continue making plugin review videos. But I also really like to experiment with other types of videos. Then Lavibelle. Where's your mustache go, dude? Never had one, I think. No. Bart Konings asks, are you okay, Wietse? I've never been okay. Steel Fistel asks, yes, but this is better than the tube version. Well, it depends if you run it in class A or not. And those are the questions for the Q&A. Normally, I was only answering questions that would be asked to me via a Q&A question, like, ask me some questions. Right now I'm responding to comments. So if you got a question for me, leave them below underneath this video or another video of me. And I will try to answer them. I will pick out the coolest ones. Also, if you really want to have the answer to your question, ask it on patreon.com. You can find patreon.com over here. And by pledging a few dollars, you will get a priority in the Q&A sessions. I will try to do these things monthly. I'm always very busy, so I hope I can make another video by the end of this month. So, that being said, I want to end the Q&A over here. Yeah, check out Patreon, and for now, bye-bye, till next time.